everybody. I am Nayan Bhatt. I am a lead experience designer at Infosys Digital. I have done my bachelor's in user experience design from MIT Institute of Design. I have got an opportunity to work in various domains such as logistics, e-commerce, automotive UX, which is also commonly known as automotive human machine interaction. The journey for me has been incredible so far. I started off my career as an automotive HMI design intern at Tata Elxsi. My work involved designing the interfaces and enhancing the experience of the users in cars and other vehicles. When I mention vehicles, in a larger picture, it can be any kind of vehicle, two-wheeler, four-wheeler, commercial vehicles, and so on. The role of a user experience designer is very interesting and exciting, and I'm very happy to be a part of this field, which solves complex problems by translating the human needs into empathetic design solutions. Some of my past projects include designing experiences for Tata Motors vehicles, electric cars for the Indian market, the interfaces and experiences for logistic domain and e-commerce domain, as I stated earlier. What does a UX designer do? Starting off, we try to understand the market trends, understand the competitors, map the patterns, benchmarking, understand what the market is, what the trends are, what the technology is, and how it is growing, how it is evolving. So there is more to it as per your brief, but these are all a part of the secondary research, which is basically the desk research. When we go to the field, we try to understand the user behavior and the patterns. We interact with the users. This is all done through various methods. Some of the methods are just observing the user. We do not get involved or interfere in their day-to-day routine. We are participating as a third person. We observe how they are behaving, how they are responding to the surroundings, how they are responding to the situations, and understand their day-to-day activities and lives. We conduct user interviews where we understand their opinions, we ask them questions, we note what they see, what they do, what they say, and how they behave. So all of these things are a part of primary research. We derive insights from secondary and primary research, and these insights are done through various methods. We try to brainstorm with the team. We map all of these insights by having discussions. We create empathy maps, user personas, and after we get a design direction, we do a storyboarding and we create user scenarios. The solution part now I'm talking about, it can be any type of solution. It depends on your brief. It can be a tangible solution. It can be a system design. It can be a digital solution. In case of a digital solution, in the ideation phase, we create information architecture. We create prototypes, wireframes. So after all of these things are done, we deliver the design, the solution to the end user. But there is one thing that has to be consistent throughout the ideation phase, which is the usability testing. I think usability testing and design ideation and prototyping should go hand in hand. While we are creating a solution for the user, we have to understand how they are responding to our solution so that we know that what we are designing. For example, let's take a scenario of a driver. A driver performs various functions. He uses clutch to change the gear, he uses accelerator to move the car and brake, and it involves a lot of functions which are used for driving. So here our driver is our user. And there are many other controls which he is using, but he, at the same time, he has to see those controls as well. So for seeing those controls, what he is performing, there are various platforms inside a car also, like some of which are instrument cluster panel. which is right in front of the steering wheel, we see critical information on it, like battery, like speed, like engine information, and other warning signals as well. There is a infotainment system which is in between the passenger and the driver. It is accessible by both the driver and passenger. It involves entertainment, music, maps, routes, etc. Design is an intuitive process, and what is working today might not work tomorrow. So maybe after the automotive industry reaches the automation, then the entire definition of HMI will also change as per the requirement. As a beginner, the basic question which is in our mind is, what is design? We have a lot of questions about why design is needed. I remember one of our design aspirant asked me if design was visual aesthetics. To answer this, I want to just quote one of the world famous designer's words, Don Norman, the great designer's words, that beauty and brain, pleasure and usability should go hand in hand. The functionality and aesthetics should go hand in hand. What you design should be usable at the same time and attract the users as well. Like, you can think of a scenario when you go to the store and you see something, oh, this is really nice, and once you are able to use it as well, that will satisfy the user 100%. About Indian global and global education, design education system, I think we have a lot of colleges, amazing design colleges in India and other countries as well. And there are courses that are coming up according to the industry expectations and requirements. And I strongly believe that any design aspirant, if he reaches out to the industry professional or academic professional to seek guidance or review, then they would be very happy to help and guide. So if you have any queries in your head, we have professional platforms like LinkedIn, and now social media platforms also have a lot of design pages where you can approach any designer whom you want to consult, and they will be very happy to guide you. And I think to know about the courses and design colleges that the design colleges are offering, they can reach out to their seniors and know about their design journey. This will help us understand the challenges, understand their journey and the limitations that they have faced, the challenges that they have faced. So all of these things will give us a lot of exposure about what is happening, and we will also stay aware at the same time. One thing about my design journey, as a kid, I always used to love to paint and play with colors. And after my 12th, I landed up in MIT Institute of Design, where my journey of creating new innovations for a living really started. I saw myself fitting in here. I love to create new product solutions which are intuitive to use, and here I got a platform where multidisciplinary learning also happened. I had my roommate who was a product designer, I was a user experience designer. We used to discuss a lot about design, about what her learnings are, what my learnings are. I think this should not be specific to a particular domain, and we should be able to understand what is desirable by the users, what is accessible by the users, by just not limiting their solutions to just screens, but also products, spaces, services, and so on. So right now in schools, I feel children do have a platform where they can show their imagination and creativity, like competitions and art rooms. But inculcating design learning in their curriculum will change everything. This will shape their minds from the very beginning itself, where children are the most creative beings, and they do not limit their imagination to a specific domain. And I think if design thinking is introduced in schools, it will help them provide a particular platform where they can create the best learnings by setting a new meaning to design itself, which is very exciting. I would want to really know how they are responding to this, and they will also learn what empathy is in design. They will learn to build emotions in their innovation because they are full of emotions. Children, they hardly think logically at the very beginning stages of their life. It is full of emotions, and that is what is important in design. And this initiative will help the children explore new fields also, and I would love to see children get into design from the very beginning and brighten up our field with their imagination and creativity.